heard you were legal, I'm legal, can you kick it? Just saying, can you kick it? No? No? I saw you in dances. Is there any way possible you might teach me some of your steps? I'm really trying to get it in. I want to get the dancing. No? No? That's such a beautiful brooch. Can you take me to the mall when we go together? Just saying, no? No? God, I don't know why I'm talking to you, really. Reverend Ashley didn't tell the truth when he said, if you want to have a friend, show yourself friendly. And Minister Brown, he has somebody to hang out with. You know, Wendy, she's real nice. He just wants me to be all by myself talking about holding on to my values and stuff. He's not holding on to his values at nighttime. People can't really see who I am. They can't see my worth. They can't see that they judge me differently than who I am. God, I don't know if legitimately I put out a mistaken identity, but I want people to see me for who I am on today. We have different opportunities in our life in which we can shape the perception of what people think about us. So when I asked my brother, could we kick it? I looked at my clothes and was like, I ain't trying to go nowhere with you. You know, and nobody want to be seen in the mall with somebody that look like I look. And, you know, if I dance with the best dancer, then people might start talking about her. What have people said about you that shook you at the core of who you were? When you tried to maintain relationships and friendships with other individuals, how were you rejected? Even in your own household, you know, everybody don't have the best mother and the best father, you know. And there's a statement that said, you act just like your daddy. Mom, you don't really like my daddy. I'm trying to understand why all of these negative things are shaping and defining me. And so I began to respond the way people have identified me. Most of us will do that. But think about it for a moment. What's the worst thing that you've ever said about somebody? What was the worst thing that somebody said about you? Those things will define or determine how valuable of a relationship that you can have with people. And so if you want to have productive relationships, if you want things to be different in your life, then you've got to make a decision to operate differently. And I believe we have different opportunities to reset the game. How many of you know anything about resetting the game in your life? I said, when you're going from one school to another, it's an opportunity to reset the game. If you were in high school and it didn't work out for you in high school, you got bullied. When you go to a new college, you have an opportunity to reset the game. Even during the summertime, you go back after summertime, you have an opportunity to reset any particular game in your life. And I know it can be easy being in church. I've even called church boy, church girl. I done heard them all. You know, softy, nerd. It's not bad being a nerd, though. I was one of those nerds, so, you know, I'll take that one. The reality is that who you are is going to define where you go. Because people are going to treat you the way that you demand to be treated. We all know the book of Mark. I don't want to get into the word so deep, but when you look at the book of Mark, there was a story in there when Jesus was out and ministering. He was with his disciples, and he said to the disciples, who do they say that I am? The disciples came back, and he said, well, some say that you're John the Baptist. Some say that you're Elijah or a prophet. And so he asked them a question. Who do you say that I am? So I ask you that question. Who do you say that you are? How do you want people to see you? If somebody calls you stupid, does that define that you're actually stupid? If someone says that they're not going to love you and that you're not lovable, does that mean lovable? Sometimes we adopt mistaken identities and mistaken characteristics about ourselves that interrupt our opportunity and ability to have healthy relationships with other individuals. And so as we begin this whole new school year, and you know, we got some older students in here as well, the truth is we all have a chance to change what other people think about us by changing our behavior and our own attitude and how we look at ourselves. And so as we go off into college, as we go into our high school years, and just think about it, when you come out of the eighth grade, for those schools, we have some people that in all different levels, but coming out of the eighth grade, you know, you were in eighth grade. You were running to school, and you know, everything you said, you had everybody looking up to you in the eighth grade. You go into the ninth grade, you at the bottom of the totem pole again. It's like you guys start all because now the seniors are running the school. But even as a freshman, you can shape your identity. Because if somebody sees something about you that they don't find interesting, and they begin to label you negatively, you have the power and the ability to nip that in the bud even as a freshman. See, oftentimes what happens is we portray how we feel. And that's why it begins with us. So if you're walking into your freshman year in high school, what you have the ability to do is be outgoing, charismatic, you know, find out what your interests in your lives are and connect with other individuals by joining activities and things of that nature. And so you have a chance to put out who you are before somebody else defines who you are. Even as a freshman, they can't just tell you, you know, you are what they want to see in you. And as you come into who you are, as you grow, as you evolve, I understand that there are challenges within our own household that shapes us. So I don't want to pretend that it's easy. I don't want to pretend that you don't have conflict at home sometimes. That will minimize your own self-worth and your own value. And so for those of you that might have pulled a card, somebody has heard that they were stupid at home. It didn't come from the rest of the world. It came at home. Somebody at home heard that they were fast or, you know, they were promiscuous at home. Somebody at home heard negative attributes about themselves from the very individuals that they thought should love them, build them up, and not tear them down. You take those challenges and those issues and then you go out to the rest of the world. If you hear long enough that you're stupid, how long is it going to take you to stop trying to be smart? I mean, let's just think about it. You call me stupid, you call me stupid, she called me stupid, then grandma called me stupid, and then grandpa come back and he called me stupid too. After a while, I'm going to think that they may know a little bit more than I know. And so when I'm over here kicking it with my friends or the people that I would like to be my friends, for fear of them thinking that I'm stupid as well, I may not interact with them the way that I desire to. And so, how many of us have had dead weight? There's just some people you just don't want to be around. Perfect example. Everybody in your class has somebody that's pessimistic. That if we all say the sky is blue, they're going to say the sky is gray. If we all say that it's nice outside, no, it could be better. There's always somebody in the bunch that is very, very pessimistic. And after a while, you won't be around them. And so what is happening is it's a self-fulfilling prophecy coming to pass. Nobody want to be my friends, you know, because you're not friendly. It's just being real. You're not friendly. You got a frown on your face. You don't look nice. You put your guard up before everybody else can even attack you, so you are on the offense instead of being on the defense. And you don't want to hear anything from anybody. Now, is that a great way to develop a healthy relationship? After a while, even if you are able to interact and communicate with someone, they're going to get exhausted because they have to keep lifting you up and encouraging you. And so when you keep pushing people away, when you keep being antagonistic, then the very thing that elevate that so that that